Alright, so this piece is probably one of my favorites. It's not like so crazy. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to just talk about my wigs that I have. It's my current obsession, and the really, you know, cool thing about wigs and the reason why I'm currently obsessed is because I'm so lazy and I'm so busy a lot of times that by the time I'm done doing my makeup, like, who wants to do your hair, you know? Like, thankfully I was blessed with really, really good hair, and so therefore I don't have to put that much effort. But the look still looks dull, it looks bland, it can get very boring. And so a way to spice up your look, your photo shoots, just kind of like do all of these things without damaging your hair and spending so much time and effort and money into it, is just popping on a wig. So without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and get into some of my favorite wigs and the brands I'm currently buying from. So this is the first wig. This is from wigsby.com. I'll have the links and the codes down below if you'd want to take a look. I forgot the name, but I saw like this actress wearing a wig like this, and it's kind of like their default picture for this wig, and I just had to order it. So it's kind of like this little fairy tale renaissance kind of vibe, and I'll have a name down below. But this is the box that it comes in. And in it is a comb. You have a wig cap, which I'm wearing, and the wig, of course. And then it's got extra clips for in case you have any loose clips and combs. An extra wig cap here, a black wig cap here, and then just a little how-to little catalog thing here with some more coupons if you want to use them on your next order. How to take on your natural look wig. So it also keeps a directions on how to take care of your wig, how to wash it, rinse it, condition it, and dry it, and style it, of course. So it's pretty cool. I really liked their customer service as well. They're pretty on top of it. They kept, like, I had forgot that I ordered this wig, and they just kept, like, every week giving me reminders through email, like, we're sorry that your wig is back ordered, like, it's gonna be going out in shipping soon. Then it gave me the shipping and the tracking information, and then finally my wig came. And then they followed up with an email as well. So they are on top of it, and I really like it. Wearing it right now, it's so fluffy, it's synthetic, but you would never ever tell. Like, it's just such a good quality, very loose, shiny, but not plastic shiny fake look. Like, I've gotten a lot of compliments in it. It's the only wig that I have that's kind of like a brunette, like very tight curls with kind of like a reddish purplish undertone, which really complements my skin tone personally, because I'm kind of like on the yellow side. And sometimes the red in this wig brings out the pinkness in my body as well. So it's super cute. I really liked it. And of course it comes with like a little lace front, which you just trim to your hairline. So that was quick. That was easy. It comes with like three clips. One here, two here. It doesn't have the back clip over here, but it's got like the drawstring, so you can make it tight around your head. And yeah, it's super cute. It comes way below my bosom area, so that's cute because I like my hair to go like flow around my body and not just stop anywhere above my breast. So I love this wig. This is one of my favorite wigs. So I hope you guys like it too. And on to the next wig. Alright, so this piece is probably one of my favorite. Reason being is because it's not super crazy, unnatural, or out there. It pretty much resembles kind of like my natural hair tone and the style that I wear, usually down the part with a whole bunch of baby hairs. So I had to add the baby hairs, which I'll go into styling right now. And that kind of styling goes into pretty much all of the wigs that I wear. But before I get into that, just one more thing about this wig. It's from Eva Hair, so they're really, really good. I love this piece. It's a Kardashian, Kim Kardashian inspired. So as you can tell, it's like really long, it's really flowy. You're supposed to kind of part it in the middle, but I'm sure you can make it look different kind of styles. You could put it up in a ponytail, you could side part it, whatever you want to do. It also takes high heat and it's really easy to maintain because it's like all black. You could style it, you can cut it, but I'm going to keep it long and flowy like this because I like that. Because if I'm going to wear a wig, like, it has to look super extra but also natural at the same time, where it could be something I grew. But yeah, this is how I style my wigs. Basically, when they come intact, like when you first open them, they come with a whole bunch of lace front attached on all sides, and they come very, very thick. There's almost no part. So basically what I do is I cut around the lace front to fit my natural hairline and the way that I part it. So if you always rock side parts and you want to rock your wig at the side part, then make sure you're wearing the side part. And then when you style it, make sure it lines up. And then I start plucking so that it can become a part in the middle or wherever part you want to have it on. And then I just take a little bit of concealer or powder or liquid concealer, whatever you want. I usually use cream, set it with the powder, and just use like a flat brush, and then I just start lining it. So all of this is concealer and it looks like it's part of, like, it looks very, very natural. Another thing is that I take a razor and I, off of the very few front hairs, I shave them off so that they could look like baby hairs. So it kind of blends with my baby hairs and it's not like just one thick, fake kind of edge. Like, I do not like that because my natural hair doesn't do that. So you could immediately tell if someone's wearing a wig by that. So once I do have the baby hairs both out, like from my natural hair and the wig hair, I just take a toothbrush. This is all dirty because it's got like hair mascara in it and stuff, so that's why it's dirty. So I only use it for my hair, and I brush out the baby hairs. So once the baby hairs are all brushed out, I'll take some Sleek Edge Control. This is by Design Essentials. And it looks like this. And then basically what I do is I just dab a little bit onto the toothbrush. And then, let me move forward here. And then I just clean them up like this so they look very styled. So first I brush them down and in, and then I just put my finger there, and then the bottom half of my finger I brush sideways so it looks like that. Same with this, you brush it down and in, and then go like that, and that part you brush sideways. So that's like how I style my baby hairs. Not even just like when I'm wearing a wig, but like anytime I use this kind of method. Also, sometimes you'll see the lace front. The lace is always gonna be like this kind of skeleton, like skin tone, and sometimes you'll see it right above your hairline. So for that, I put a little bit of mascara on this. As you can tell, it's dirty, or I'll just get an eyeshadow brush, dip it into some eyebrow color or eyeshadow, like dark color, and then just kind of line my hairline, and it'll definitely conceal it. So that is how I make it look natural, and I'm loving this look. I just go like this with the leftover product on my hairbrush or on my toothbrush so that there's no flyaways. It's so silky and soft that it's like it gives flyaways just like real hair. So it's like you still have to maintain it and tame it. And I really like it because my hair is like a couple shades lighter than this, so it really is like a different contrast, you know, that it gives. And someone said that I look like I could be a different race when I wear this. So I look like I'm more Peruvian. Someone said I look like I'm black. I think it's exotic. I think it's cute. And I think that black hair goes with like everything. I think you could rock it. It gives it like a little bit more like bad girl vibe, like villain, and that's cute. I mean, when I wear my like honey brown hair, like it's a little bit more like angelic and sweet and stuff. But so for my next wig, it's like this little strawberry pastel pink color, and it's super, super cute. It really reminds me of Nikita Dragon, and she's bomb, and she rocks some really, really cool styles. So this color definitely reminds me of her. I am in love with this. I wore it for a Coachella-inspired, like, desert look, because this is so like that type of generation, and this is super cute. It's like it came actually with like even more big Victoria's Secret curls. I've brushed it out since then, and I still love the look. It still keeps its body, and it's still very silky and beautiful. It's thick, it's gorgeous, it's amazing. This is from Everyday Wigs. And it comes with a brush as well, wig caps, and instructions and stuff like that. If you have a quick scan app, you could do that to here. So you can add them on their website, their Instagram, you can contact them. And here are the care instructions. So I really, really love this wig. I still have to do like some more customizing to it, because I feel like it's very, very volume me up here, which is not a bad thing. You want to have more, and then you can remove and pluck them, than to buy a wig and it's not enough volume for those that need it. So over here you can barely see like the line, and so I would just probably in the future, I'm not really bugging about it now, but like in the future I could definitely like probably go and pluck some so that this could be a little bit more noticeable and distinct, so you could actually see a part. So yeah, besides that, I'm loving this wig. It's super cute. I love pink anyways, like who doesn't? So this next wig is from a company called Uni Wigs. And I ordered a blonde one, but I didn't want like full blonde. I still wanted it to kind of transition so that I can get used to this type of look. So I got like an ombre style. So that means that the roots are still dark and then it transitions into a lighter color, the blonde gold color. So I think it's really, really cute. I am in love with this wig. It's still synthetic, it's shiny, it looks healthy, it changes your look super easily. The customer service on this as well was super fast. Like, this one was in stock, it was sent to me right away. I absolutely love this look. Like, it is so, so cute. As you can see, it's like super flowy. It's so thick and pure and like milky. Like, it's the perfect, perfect quality. And 1 through 10, I would give it like literally a 10. So yeah, this is the wig. Let me know what you guys think. Like, I'm too chicken to try a color like this or to go light, but I mean, with this wig, like, why would you need to? Why would you go through hours of processing? And something like this could take more than one session. So who got time for that? Like, when putting on this wig literally took me 5 minutes. Make sure you guys remember this. You'll see it a lot on my Instagram coming up and on my YouTube. So yeah. And that is it for all of my favorite wigs and the try-ons and review. So if you had any questions, please leave them down below. I read every single comment and everybody's messages, trust me, like 100%. I might not reply to all of them, but I definitely see the good, the bad, and the ugly. And if you did have a question, I will answer it as well. So leave them down below. Don't forget to rate, like, comment, subscribe, turn on post notifications if you like what you see. Don't forget to add my Instagram as well, guys. I'm like 24/7 on Instagram and Insta story, and I always go live. So if you had any questions, I might be answering them live as well. All right, guys, thanks for tuning in. Until next time.